Good morning. I'm Raiha Sandalwala. I'm going to take a session on user interface. So before proceeding, let's go through the content. First is introduction to user interface, layouts, user interface controls, menus and toasts, notifications, other interesting user interfaces. In this, we'll cover list view, dialogues, date picker and sliding drawer. So now let's start with our first topic. Introduction to user interface. User interface is one of the most important features of Android, and it is also something which consumes a lot of time. This is because from the user's point of view, we want our applications to be captivating. Okay. So now what is user interface? It is anything and everything that the user sees on the screen and can interact with. So Android provides various pre-built components like layouts, which provide a uniform look and feel in the application. There are also some UI controls like buttons, which we have seen in the previous session, text boxes and check boxes, radio buttons. These are the common UI controls which we see on the registration forms on the various websites. Usually when we register to Facebook and all, we see these. There are also dialogues, notifications and menus. So we'll see them in the later on. Now there are two approaches to implement user interface. First is we write the Java, first is procedural and the second is declarative. In the procedural approach, we write the Java code, and in declarative approach, we write XML code, which is similar to the HTML of a web page. And so the best practice is to start with the XML file and declare most of the user interface, and then switch to the Java code to implement the user interface logic. Okay. So we'll implementing the best approach in our applications. So we'll see our next topic, that are Android layouts. What is a layout? A layout is a systematic arrangement of components on the screen. It provides a uniform look and feel to the applications. Okay. So there are again two ways of declaring layouts, one in the XML file that we just saw and another programmatically. And also again the convenient method is to start with the XML file and then switch to the Java code. Now we'll see what are the types of layouts. Mainly there are four types of layouts: linear layout, table layout, grid layout and relative layout. Linear layout is again subdivided into two categories: horizontal layout and vertical layout. So we'll see coding of all the four layouts one by one. Before that, let's see the snapshot. This is the linear layout. Okay. Again, in linear layout, this is the vertical type of layout. So the components are arranged in the vertical order one by one. It can also be arranged horizontally. Okay, so in linear layout, everything is arranged in the line, either vertical or horizontal. So this is the output which we are going to achieve, which we want to achieve. So let's see the code for it. So here are a lot of applications. I have already made all these applications. Now the first application is linear layout. This is the one, linear vertical. Let me just open this. This is the Java code. We don't have any work of the Java code here right now. So we'll go to the layout folder. So this is the XML file of the linear layout application. I'm sorry, this is, let me. By default, actually what happens is when we create a new application, the application is in relative layout. So we can just edit it. Here it gives me a building error. It is because we are down. The closing tab is again of relative layout. So I have to just edit it for the linear layout. Now it is okay. Okay. So this is the relative layout tag. In this layout, width and height are defined, which is will be uniform for all the for the whole application. Now here I am defining four buttons. These are the four buttons. I'll scroll it slowly because yesterday we got the feedback that it is too fast, okay. So these are the four buttons. ID, as we have seen in the previous session, it has to be different, unique for all the buttons, so that when we use this ID for instantiating the button in the Java code, it has to be unique for each button. Now these are the various parameters of the button: layout width and layout height for defining the width and height of the button. Wrap content means that the text which is written on the button, it will coordinate with the size of the button. That is, wrap content means the size of the button will be adjusted according to the text written on it. Align parent left and align parent top means that the button will be aligned to the left top of the screen. Text is 1.1, we can again edit it. So these are the similar kind of parameters. Now let's look at a Java file. We have done nothing in the Java file. It is same. These are the two predefined methods. Okay. Now here we see inflator. Inflator is used to instantiate the XML file. Now we'll see the output in the emulator. Usually the output takes a lot of time. So what I have done is I have already installed all the applications. Okay, it's not showing. I'll again do it once. Once again I'll run this in the Project Explorer, linear vertical layout, run as Android application. Okay. So since we are running it for the first time, it will take some time. Also, I forgot to show you the graphical view. This is the XML file and here is the graphical view. Okay, it's showing linear vertical, but the buttons are here in horizontal order. Let me change this. Yeah, when we click on this button, set vertical orientation, all this will come in vertical order. Let me again run this, run this Android application, save changes. Yes, we have just now done something, and so it asks, prompts every time to save the changes. Yes, this is the emulator. So the output will be same as what we saw in the graphical view. So let's move to our slides. I'll again show the output after some time when it, okay, I think it is showing something here. So this is the output in the emulator. All the buttons are below each one another. So this is a simple thing, just shows the layout of the various components. Now we see the next type of layout. So this is a snapshot of the grid layout. In grid layout, the components are arranged in the forms of rows and columns. So these are the two rows and the four columns. Okay. So here one thing to be noted is this button 1.3 is slightly longer than the other buttons, and the button just below it 2.3 does not occupy the whole space of the column. That is, it does not follow the match parent property. It follows wrap content, which we have just seen in the previous layout. Okay. So this is something to be noted. Now let's see its again the coding, this which we have seen. I am closing this application. Now I will start grid layout. Okay, res folder in layout, this is the grid layout. Let me zoom this. So this is the graphical view of the grid layout. The similar kind of output we'll be seeing. So this is the XML file. Okay, here grid layout tag is there. Again, there are some buttons. I'm scrolling them down slowly as per the feedback. Okay, there will be 8 buttons. All the buttons will have different ID. Okay, so these are the 8 buttons. I'm not showing all of them. So now let's see their parameters. column count equal to 9 means maximum we can have 9 columns here. This is style, button style small, which means the small buttons will appear here. We can also add some other features in the styling like color and color of the background of the button or color of the button text. We can add all these styles. Layout column equal to 0 and layout row equal to 0, these two, which means that this particular button is in the 0th column and in the 0th row. Layout gravity equal to left means this button will be aligned towards the left. Text is 1.1, that is 1.1 will be displayed on the text. Again, this is the second button, different ID. Layout column equal to 2, which means that this button is in second column and 0th row. Again, layout gravity equal to left means aligned towards the left. So, since the arrangement is in the form of rows and columns, here we define which row and which column starts from 0, index starts from 0, 0, 0. Okay. Again, here we see something different. Layout width is equal to 88 dp. Now, dp is density pixel. It is one of the units of defining the width or even the height of the button. Okay, column equal to 4, row equal to 0. That is, this is in 4th column and 0th row. We have seen the graphical view. Now, let's see the output. Actually, I have already compiled all these applications once. So, I am trying that. We see all here, I click on the installed ones and show you so that we don't waste much time. Yeah, I found here grid layout. So, I am clicking on this grid layout and here we see the output, same as what we saw in the graphical view. Okay. So, when we click on any of the icon of APK files, we see the application. Now, again we see the next type of layout, grid layout. After that has come table layout. So, here also the components are arranged in the forms of rows and columns. These are two rows and the four columns. Here the difference is that 1.3 is again longer than the other buttons, but the button 2.3 occupies whole of the space of the column, unlike the previous one. Okay, here it did not occupy whole space. Here it is occupying the whole space. So, this is implementing a match parent property, that is it is matching the width of the parent here. Now, let's see the code. I'm closing this grid layout now. Here is table layout. I have done no coding here. I'm just showing the arrangement of various components. There is no Java coding in these layouts. Okay. So, this is table layout. Okay. This is the graphical view, same thing we will be seeing in the output also. So, now, let us see the XML file. This is the XML file, table layout tag. Here there is one difference that all the components will be specified in the form of rows. So, this is the first row. First row contains this button 1, button 2, button 3. And button 4. Okay, I'll be going slow. So here is the end of the first tag, that is first row ends here with the four buttons. Okay. So this is again table row tag, that is here from here we start the next row. So we have to define various rows and in that the components. I'm just scrolling down so that you can see the whole code. Okay, so this is the end of table row and the table layout tag. Now we'll see the various parameters. ID we have seen, width and height same. I don't think there is any other different parameter here. Graphical layout we have seen. Now we'll see the output. Okay. Let me just go back. I click on menu and I can see all the applications that are already compiled and installed. So we have seen table layout here, right? So this is the output for table layout, same as what we saw in the snapshot and in graphical view. Okay. Now let's switch to the fourth and the last type of layout, that is the relative layout. This is the relative layout. Here there is no fixed pattern of the components. We can drag and drop them anywhere. So by default, an application, when we create an application, it is in relative layout. It follows this relative layout. Okay. So let's see in Eclipse IDE, the XML file. Here I am opening the relative layout. Okay, so let me zoom. So this is the graphical view of the relative layout application. We can just drag and drop the things anywhere. Okay, I can do it here also. No effect on the output will come. I mean, output will be different, but no change in the properties as such. Okay, so this is the XML file for relative layout. Here, since there is no rows and columns in particularly which we define, so the positions of the various parameters are defined in relative to each other. One of the button will be act as a parent button, and all the other buttons or all the other components will be in related to that position, will show their, will have their positions in terms of that button. Okay. So this is relative layout tag, button ID, button 3 here. I'm just showing you the code. Okay, so width and height we have seen, align top we have seen, margin equal to 33 dp. That is this button, it has top margin of 33 density pixel. Text is 3.1. Again, align parent top equal to true, which means this button acts as a parent button. It has right margin of 26 density pixels, top margin of 29 density pixel. Also to left of ID button 2, that is this button 1 is towards the left of button 2. So, top margin is 29 density pixel. We have seen the graphical view. Now, let us see the output in the emulator. Again, I go back, relative layout. So, this is the output in the emulator. Okay, now here, this is all about layouts. Save changes, yes, does not matter. Now we go to our next topic, Android UI controls. These are the few basic input controls. As I told earlier, these are the interactive components of an application. We see them when we usually fill a form on the websites. So we will see these components one by one in the form of a form. I have created a registration form, so we will see all these components. I will explain a little bit here. Text view and edit text are together known as text fields. In text view is a kind of label, and in edit text we can write something, that is name or something else. Button has a text, or it can also contain an icon. When we click on this button, something happens. So we have to write the Java code for this. Then radio buttons, we can select only one option from a given set of options in radio button. Checkboxes, we can select multiple options from a given set of options in the checkbox. Okay, spinner is a kind of drop down list. So we will see them one by one. Let us first see the snapshot of the form, which I am going to show. This is the snapshot. This first name, last name, gender, country and occupation, these all are the text view, or you can say kind of labels. Here this is an edit text, we can write here. Here these are the checkboxes, spinners, and radio buttons, spinner, checkboxes, and these are again the two buttons. Okay, so we'll see its code. From here, there's a little bit of Java code in every application. So this is the Java code. Let me also open the XML file. Okay, form.xml. So we'll first see the XML file. Okay. Here is the XML file. So we have defined table layout here. First row contains edit text and text view as we show in the snapshot. EMS is also kind of unit for defining the width of the edit text. So this is the second row. I'm just scrolling down slowly so you can view the whole code. Second row, end of second row. Okay, in the same way there are all the other rows here, radio group, that is radio buttons are defined. So now let's see the Java code here. Now here we have defined the various UI controls. These are the variables, actually not the objects. Just typing mistake. Okay, so here we define various variables of the classes which we have used. Here is the string of array of strings. In this we define, we have declared various country names. So we'll see what is the use of this array of strings. Okay, here we instantiate the edit text and the button, also spinner. Now event handling is done on spinner here in this code. What is happening is, it is just array adapter is used to pull the content from the string of array. Array of strings, So here that the array we saw, array adapter will pull the contents from this array into the spinner. Okay. This is the whole code. Now event handling is done on the reset button. Here we call onClick method. OnClick is a callback method of the event listener interface. Event listener is an interface of view class. So here this is the inner class which she was telling about in the previous session, which Pradnya was telling about. Okay. So here we define the onClick method. Here what is happening is, in reset button, when we click on the reset button, the form will reset. That is, it will come back to its original value where nothing was written in the form. Okay. So this is all about reset button. Now submit button. Usually what happens is, when we click on submit button, the form is reset. Also all the values are stored in the database when we click on submit button. So here we kind of assume that all the values will be stored in database, and again on clicking submit button also here, the form will reset. So this is the whole code for submit button. Now these are the two empty methods. We have to write these methods because we are implementing event listener interface. So these are the methods in event listener interface which we have to write. Okay. So now let's see the output in the emulator. Where is form? Lot of applications are installed here. So let me search. Yes, here is the form. Okay, I hope you are visible here. This is text view, edit text I am writing here. First name, suppose Android. Second name, workshop, for example. Now this is radio button. I'm selecting female. Spinner here contains the list of all the countries. We can drag up and down to view the whole list. Okay. I'm selecting India here. Now these are the two check boxes. I hope these are visible, student as well as teacher. So the difference between radio button and check boxes is this. In radio button, we can select only one option at a time. In check boxes, multiple options. So we click on submit button and the form is again reset. Okay, same will happen when we click on reset button. So this is all about UI controls. This is the form, snapshot of the filled form. Now we go to our next topic, that is menus and toast. What is a menu? This is a common user interface in any of the electronic device, either mobile or tablet. This is the most common button which we will see. Every device contains the menu button. When we click on this menu button, we see the list of all the applications that are stored in our device. Okay, so everyone who has a mobile or a tablet must have gone through this option at least. Types of menu, options menu. This is a primary collection of menu items. So we use options menu when we have to globally affect an application, that is when we have to search, compose mail or do some kind of settings. Now next is pop-up menu. Okay, a pop-up menu displays list of items in a vertical list. So it is a kind of list which displays in the form of a pop-up. So these are the two types of menus. Now we'll see what a toast is. A toast provides a simple feedback operation. When we click on a button, for example, or on any of the options in the menu, a feedback operation, feedback about an operation will rise. So if we click on any of this, we'll see this toast. It is a kind of tool tip, we can say. Okay, so now let's see the snapshot of the options menu. So this is the snapshot of the options menu. Again, I will not show all the snapshots. This is the snapshot for the pop-up menu. So this we are going to achieve in our output. Now let's see the coding in our Eclipse IDE for both these menus. Okay, so I'm closing this. Android menus. This is the Java file layout. Here we have two XML files, main.xml and menu.xml. So now let's see what it has main.xml has. In main.xml, this is linear layout is defined and a simple text view is there, nothing else. This is the graphical view. Click on menu to show menu items. Only this content is there in the main.xml file. Now let's see menu.xml. So this is the menu.xml file. Here six items are defined. Okay, I'm just showing you the code first. So here are the six items with these three parameters. First is the ID, which has to be different. Item is basically when we click on the options, options button, we see the various options. So those options are the items. Okay. So now Android icon. Icon is a small picture which comes with the text, then title. Here it is bookmark. So this text will be written when we see the options. Similar kinds of parameters, ID, icon and title. ID, all are different for all the six items here. Icon is optional, not necessary to mention. Okay. So now let's see the Java code. This is the Java file. Menu inflator is used to instantiate the menu.xml file. Now here event handling is done for the items. Switch case is used here. When we click on the menu button, we will see six options, and when we click on any of them, a toast will appear. We will see what is a toast is, it will be more clear when we see the output. Okay. So a feedback of what button we have pressed will appear in the toast. suppose we press the bookmark button, so the text bookmark is selected will appear in the toast. So similar kind of cases with different IDs and texts. So, I'm scrolling just to show the code. This is the whole code. Now let's see the output of this options menu in the emulator. See, all these are already compiled, so I can see on the emulator. You'll have to run it once to see all these options. Android menus. Click on the menu to show menu items. I'm clicking on this menu button here. So I see these six options. These six items. When I click on the save, save is selected. So this save is selected is a toast. Again, I'll show you. When I click on menu, these six options, bookmark is selected. Okay, so this is all about options menu. Now we'll see what is the pop-up menu. So this is the snapshot. I'll show you the Eclipse code now. Menu pop-up, okay, this is the Java file, here again two XML files, main.xml and menu layout.xml. So here in main.xml, let's see what is there. In main.xml, there is a button. Layout gravity equal to center, which means that this button is placed in the center. Top margin is 42 dp, dip is again density pixel, nothing else. Okay, so the in graphical view, I hope it is visible. Let me, okay, this is the button showing show pop-up text. This is the graphical view. Now let's see the Java code. Here three variables are again declared of these classes, layout inflator, pop-up window and view. Layout inflator is used to instantiate the XML file. Okay. Now here event handling is done on the pop-up window. This is show pop-up method. When we click on the what happens? When we click on the button, the pop-up window appears. That is the list of the various options. So this is the event handling. Here width and height of the pop-up window is declared. We can also declare this in the XML file. While declaring layouts, while studying about layouts, we saw that we can declare them in two ways, one in XML file and other programmatically. So, layout parameters can also be declared programmatically. Width and height we are declaring, defining here. Okay. These are again three methods for the three options. I guess we have missed the menu layout XML. So we have seen that also before the Java, proceeding with the Java code. Here three options will appear when we click on the button pop-up menu. Okay, these will be the three options. This is the XML file, menu layout.xml. Okay, so here again the second method of onClick, second way of implementing onClick method is here. When we click on any one of these buttons, options a toast will appear. This is the text view, linear layout. Here is the background. The various color codes are there, fixed color codes in the Android, so you can use any of them. So this is the Java code of text, a toast will appear here. Yeah, the code is available. We have uploaded the code in Moodle as well as GitHub links, or videos are also there. All are there on the GitHub. So you can try the code yourself. I will see the output in the emulator, pop-up menu, show pop-up, these three options. When we click on any of them, a toast will appear, tabbed search. This is the toast. Again, I can show you, share, tabbed share. Okay, so this is all about menus. Now, probably I'll have to rush through the session. Now, next is notifications. Okay, so what are notifications? Usually when we get a missed call or a message in our phones or tablets, we get a notification for that. So these are the notifications. We'll see the application. Before that, this is the snapshot of the notification. These will be implementing. I have actually made two applications for the notification. I'll quickly show them now. In one, there will be only a text, that is, you can continue with the work. In the second notification, I'll be showing a website. Okay. So, an Eclipse notification demo. So, I'll only explain the Java code now, not much of the XML file from here. This is the XML file and the graphical view of that. It contains only one button, nothing else. So this is the Java code. Here button B is declared and instantiated. Event handling on the button. Notification is manager is used to create a notification. A context is the context of the current activity, what is currently going on in the application. Then title and details of the notification. Okay, intent is used to switch to the next activity. Here we can see this line. This means that this particular function is deprecated, which means something else better is available here. But if we use the older version also, it will not show error. It will just show a warning that this particular method is deprecated. Here, suppress warning, deprecation it will show. Nothing else. Okay. So, since I made the application in 4.0.3 and now I am compiling it in 4.2, that is why this deprecation warning is come. Okay, now we will see the output in the emulator. Pending intent gives a token to the foreign application. In this case, it will give a token to the notification manager. Okay, and with the help of intent, we will switch to the details of the notification. We will see what notify. When I click on this button, send notification, I can see the notification here. When I drag this down, I have the notification. You have been notified. Sorry. Okay. See, you have been notified. Continue with what you are doing. I hope it's visible. Now again, if I close this, I click on this, it is closed, and I come back to the original screen. So this is the first example. Now let's see the second one. In second one, that is this one, I'm showing an website in the notification. This is because it is a kind of push message that we receive on our mobile phones. It contains the links of various websites. So in notification itself, we can have links of various websites. This is the graphical view. I'm rushing now. So this is the graphical view of the XML file. Now the Java code is more or less similar. It's just that here I am defining a string which contains the URL of a website. Okay. Here almost more or less the similar kind of code. So you can try it. I'm showing you the output straight away in the emulator. Android notification. So when we click on this button, send a notification, here the notification will appear. When we click on this, URL of the website, here the website will be opened. This will take a little time. When we give the URL, the emulator takes little time. So this is the IIT Bombay website. Okay, so this website will be shown. So this is all about notifications. Now our next topic, list view. A list view is a view group, it displays a scrollable items. Okay, here adapter is used to pull the content from an array or database. We have to use an array in the Java code or code for the database so that we can pull the content from that array to the list view. Okay, now let's see the snapshot, how it looks like. This is the output of the list view. This is what we have to achieve. Okay, here are the list of fruits. Now let's see the in the Eclipse IDE the code. Here some error appeared. Okay, already we have seen this, so not to bother. List view. Also the layout file. In layout file, this is the graphical view. Here this is the list view widget. List view widget comes in the composite category. Here we can just drag and drop it from here. Okay, so this is the list view. It is not only used to display just the display the items, it has many other applications also. So I am showing you the just the basic one. This is the Java code. Here this is the function list display. Now let's go to the function. Before that, here I am declaring an array also, array of fruits, named fruits I am declaring and instantiating here. Now in this method, I am adding the various names of the fruits to the fruits array again. So these items, apple will be added to fruit array here, all the five components will be added to here to the fruits array. Okay. Now the code for the list view is instantiated here, and array adapter is used to pull the content from the array to the list view. Okay, so now let's see the output. I'm going to the home screen menu from here. So let me just search the list view here. Okay, here it is. So this is the list view. As I said, you can use list view in many other complex applications also. Okay. Now let's go to our next topic, dialogues in Android. Now what are dialogues? Dialogue is a small window. Usually when we close any text editor without saving it, so a dialog box appears that if you want to save it. Here also when I was about to close or run the application, a dialog box appeared that do you want to save this. So these are the basic examples of dialog box. Let's see the snapshot first. Here is the snapshot, a button is there. When we will click on this button, an alert box will appear. So let's see the Java code quickly. Dialog box. Okay. Also the layout file. This is the layout file graphical view. Here it contains a simple button, nothing else. So this is the Java file. I'm just showing you the code. Alert dialog builder is used to create the dialog. Okay. When we click on yes, two options will appear. When we click on show alert box will appear. On that, two messages will be there. Two buttons will be there. Sorry, yes or no. So we'll see what will happen on yes and no. In the output. This is just the code for it. It is available. So let me search where is the dialog bar. Okay. Here we This is the button show alert box. When we click on this, here we get a dialog box. It says click yes to exit. So when we click on yes, this application will be closed. So before closing, let me click on no. When we click on no, what happens is nothing will happen. We'll again go back to the previous screen. And when we click on yes, this application will be closed. So we go back to the home screen. So this is all about dialog box. Now the next topic, date picker. Date picker is simply used to set date in our application. This is a simple widget. I'll now not be showing the code because we are running short of time. I'll not explaining the code. I'll just show you the output. Now you can try the code yourself. It has been uploaded on the GitHub link. Okay. So I'm showing you the application for date picker. So what I do is I'll show you the snapshot. Okay, so this is the snapshot of the date picker application. Here date is displayed. Here this is the date picker widget. Okay, this upper is the text view. And here this is the button, change button. When we'll click on this change button, an alert box or a pop-up will appear to set the date. So this kind of pop-up, set date, will appear here. We can set date, we can click on this plus and minus to set the date, and when we click on set, the date will be set. Here in previous one, the date was Feb 23. Now on clicking the change button, this pop-up appears. On this I have set April 20. So when I'll click on the set button, the date will change to April 20. Okay. So this is all about date picker example. Now next is sliding drawer. This is something interesting. This is sliding drawer. We have also seen in the notification. When the notification came and when we dragged it down, that was a sliding drawer. So it simply hides the content on the previous screen and the components which are when we drag it down. So when all those components which are there on the upper screen now will be displayed. It contains a handle. There is a button which is named as handle. So all the components attached to this handle will now be displayed, and the previous screen will be hidden from the user. Okay. So this is the snapshot. This is the handle button. When we'll drag this upward or down, upward or horizontally, sliding drawer can be used vertically or horizontally. This is vertically I'm using. Okay. When I'll drag this handle up, I'll see these are options. So I'm not showing you the code, I'll directly show you the output, sliding drawer. I hope I find this. Yes, here it is. This is the output of the sliding drawer. This is the handle. When I'll drag this handle up, I'll see these buttons. I think these are not very much visible, but you can try the code yourself. When again I'll click on this button handle, it will again go down. Again clicking up down, that is what a sliding drawer is. So I think this is the end of the session, and I'll summarize quickly. We saw the layouts, UI controls, menus and toasts, notifications, list view, dialog box, date picker and sliding drawer at the end. These are the references. From here you can also get what I have shown. Thank you.